Hi guys, welcome back to Advanced Excel program with Preeti. The topic we shall cover today is pivot table. Before we start with the topic, let's understand why do we use pivot or when it is used. What are the ideal scenarios in which we should use a pivot table? So let's say you have a data, let's say you have a sales data or an HR data or any kind of data, you know, which has many number of columns and rows, and you want to create some meaning out of the data. You want to, generate some report or summarize your data, and you want to understand exactly how are you progressing. So for example, if it's a sales data, you want to see whether you're meeting the targets or whether, you know, you have achieved the number of orders you should have achieved in a particular month, and so on and so forth. So the various reasons you would use a pivot table is basically to answer the leadership questions, the leadership decisions that would help you further progress in taking various business decisions. So to start with, you need to have a clean data. Now when I say clean data, it means you shouldn't have any blank headings. So if you see in this case, in case, I have some number of columns over here, but let's say I didn't have some heading name over here. In such scenarios, you cannot create a pivot table. You need to have some column name for each of the columns you have. Okay, let me get the order ID back. Another reason why you cannot create a pivot is, let's say if you would have blank columns or blank rows in between, that's when you should avoid using your pivot. Okay, the minimum that you would need to take care of is that your data is clean. So no blank headings, no blank rows. So here I have around 9,905 rows, okay, which is a good amount of data, and we can create good analysis with this data. So now let's start with how to go about creating a pivot table. Firstly, to start with the selection, you can control the entire data, and the shortcut to select the entire data is Control A, or you can simply keep a cell selection anywhere inside the data. Okay, so you can just keep your cell anywhere in the data and just go to pivot. I'll click on pivot table, which is in the insert tab. You get few options over here. Let's quickly go through the options. It says select a table or range, and this is the reference which is already got selected. So as I said, you should not have any blank rows or columns in between your data. If that is taken care, automatically it will select the entire range. So if you'll see, it says A1, and as I explained earlier, all the references goes on these name boxes over here. So A1 is over here, and it says U995. So U was the last column and 995 was the last row. So it took the entire data. And then the next option we have to choose is, where do you want the pivot table to be placed? Now ideally you would create a pivot table in a new sheet. The reason being because your base data will keep on increasing, as in when you get new orders, or maybe as in when new resources are onboarded and so on. So you would ideally, in most of the scenarios, not keep your pivots in the base data, but of course if there is a requirement, you do have an option in Excel to select the existing sheet and just select on a cell. So you can just come somewhere where there is no data and just click on a cell, and you can create a pivot in the same sheet itself. But in very common scenarios, usual scenarios, we create it in a new worksheet. So I'll select a new worksheet and I'll do OK. Let me quickly show you a shortcut to create a pivot table, just in case you want to avoid working with mouse and you just want to use it completely with the keyboard. So the requirements remain the same. Your data should be clean. And let me show you the Alt shortcut which I had spoken in the first session. So to use the Alt shortcut, again, you don't have to remember these shortcuts at all. Just follow the screen shortcuts. So you start with pressing Alt. You actually need to know where that option is. So I know it's in the insert tab, and the key for the insert tab is N. So I'll press N, and for pivot it's V. You get the pivot window. You do the selection using your keyboard, the arrow keys, and then you can just do OK. In fact, if your data was clean, it automatically takes the proper range, it automatically selects new worksheet, you just have to press enter. So this is another way of creating pivot table. Either ways, you either go to insert and you insert a pivot table, or you use the shortcut. Let me delete this additional sheet. I'll keep repeating the shortcuts every time I perform any option. So the shortcut to delete a sheet is Alt L. Let's get into the pivot table. So it's very easy to understand. I know it may look a bit complicated with all the options suddenly popping up at once. Let's go step by step. The area which you need to work on, or where your tables would be displayed, is this. Okay, this is your pivot table area, which says to build a pivot table, choose fields from the pivot table field list. Okay, let's understand what comes over here. Let me just move it and expand it to show it clearly. So you get a field list in the right hand corner, and there are two tabs which gets enabled. If you notice, earlier there were only tabs till here. This is the tab which I had created in the first session. So in case you all would want to know how to create that tab, you all can refer to the session 1. You have this pivot table tools, analyze, and design tab. We will be getting into each of these tabs, analyze tab and design tab. But first, let's understand the basic, which is the field list. Okay. So to start with, before you create your pivot table, you have to know your data thoroughly. When I say that, it means you need to know what are the number of columns, what are all the columns in your base sheet, and what is the data in each column. So for example, when I say that, I mean if I'm having ordered date, then it's obvious that it's a date column. The data type is date. So there are three data types in Excel: text, number, and date. And based on that, various operations or options can be used. So that is important to know. Secondly, you would ideally know that what reports you would want to generate. Let's say you want to generate reports based on the region, or based on categories, or based on various products. So that is what you would need to know. What are the column names you would need? So for example, there are some numeric column here, stating quantity, discount, profit, sales. There is product names, subcategories, categories of the product. There are some product IDs. Usually IDs and all would be a bit rare to create in your pivot table. It would be more of, you know, using categories and subcategories, or country, state, region. It depends upon the requirement completely. We'll be creating some dummy scenarios, and we will create a few sample pivot tables. Okay, so let me go back to the sheet. Coming back to the field list. Now that we have quickly seen the base data, let's understand what comes over here in this right section. So if you notice, these are all the headings which was in the base sheet. Okay, if I'll just scroll down, you won't get to see the data inside it. That's the reason why I said you should know your data well before you start a pivot. So you know, you have these numeric data, sales, quantity, and all that. And these are some text data, there are some dates, etc. The next section is filters, columns, rows, and values. Now let's first understand these two, rows and columns. Rows is basically if you want to show something row wise. Now when I say that, for example, if you take some column, if you take some heading over here, field name, so all the column names are termed as field names in pivot. So for example, let me take category. Category is like a bigger group. So if I want to list down all the categories, all the unique values in category would be shown. Okay, you can either click and drag it, or you can just select this checkbox. It will go on adding up. You want to remove any field, you just drag it out. So first let's create a small table and see what is exactly happening. So here I took the field category in rows. When you do that, all the values inside it would be listed down one below the other. For example, if I would have taken, let's say, city, and if I would have, you know, just selected over here, it will list down all the unique values one below the other. So you have to take whichever column you would want to generate a report out of. Similarly, let me take region and keep over here. Now let's say I want to show column wise. Now when would you use column wise is when you want to give like a 3D view. You want to give you want to show the data row wise as well as column wise. So you want to give a view of two different categories at once. So for example, you want to show you know, how the sales was in each region for each category. So if I keep this field in columns, this is how it will be shown. All the values would be listed down in columns. So it's simple to remember. If you want anything to be displayed row wise, you'll keep that field in rows, and if you want to want the values to be displayed column wise, you'll keep the field here. Okay, so this will just give you headings. Okay, now when we say a summary of a data, obviously there has to be some numeric value, some calculation. That's when, you know, you can derive any meaning out of a data. So I want to know the sales of each region for each of these categories. So I'll take the sales and I'll just drag it here. Now the default operation that would happen in this is a sum, because this is numeric data. So for example, let's say if I want to perform any other operation, you can come and change the options. I'll come to that later on. Let's say if I take text, what would happen if we take text? Let me just put some text. Let me take customer name. If I would have put customer name here, the only arithmetic operation that can happen on name is count. You cannot do a sum or a max min. You can do some basic operations, but the frequently used ones are sum and count. That's all the functions you would need to know to generate the most meaningful reports in Pivot. So here I'm getting to know what are the number of customers I have in each of the region and in each of these categories. Okay, if I want to remove any field, just drag it out on the screen. I want to see how many quantities have been sold region wise, category wise. You can accordingly take that. Now comes the last field over here, which is filters. Why is filters used? Now if you see, these numbers are huge because this is data of various years. Now it is, you know, you have such consolidated data, it is very good to show trends and all, and that's why we've, you know, taken some dummy data which has data from, I guess, 2014 and so. Let's just see what are the dates. So let me take order date from here and see what all years and what all dates I have. Let me take the sales value because that was a huge value. Okay, I want to show for a specific time range. Let me take the order date. Now what happens when you put anything in your filter is there is no change that will quickly happen, I mean immediately happen when you drag this field here. But what you need to do is you have to come over here. All the filters you put will go on cascading one below the other. So here, if you click on the drop down, you'll get the dates. Let's say I want to show date of 2017. Okay, so all 2017 is filtered, I'll do okay. So now I have data only of 2017. So likewise, you can just you know, create a view of a specific date, or let's say if you want to create a view of a specific city, that all filters you can apply over here. You can add multiple number of fields over here. There is no limitation in the number of fields that you would put in each of these categories. So let's say if I want for a particular city or a state, whatever, let's just take city here. I'll select city, do okay. There's no data in this city. Okay, let's do one thing, we'll take some other field. As I said, you need to know your data well, so maybe in these regions those cities don't exist, so it will not show. Let me take some other category. Or let's say if I want a subcategory. Again, it's better to take category in filters because that is a bigger group. So let me keep subcategories here and take categories here. You can anytime shuffle also between the views. Now what I did is I took category because that is a bigger level than a subcategory. Let me filter out something. Let's say I want only furniture or office supplies. I'll do okay. So I'll get only the data for office supplies in the year 2017 and for the various subcategories. So these were the various subcategories, and only in this region the sales were done. So this is a quick overview that I've got for that particular year. Let me just remove this date. When you remove a field from here, automatically the filters will go away. So you can still apply some filters by clicking over here. You can do that also. Like, let's say I want to change the filter from here, you can do the changes from this section also. At times, mistakenly, you may, let's say, close this field. How do you get it back? You have to be inside this pivot area. You go to analyze and you go to field list. And if you'll just double click, it will go back to this area. So this was about how to create a simple pivot table. We will get into exploring the further options and creating different views in the further sessions. As of now, try to practice this, and in case you face any doubts or if you have any queries, please mention it in the comment section. Thank you so much, guys. We'll meet soon in the next session.